Hi, I'm Margaret. In this video, I want to have a closer look at class String. A string is a sequence of characters, and in Java, a string is an object. Here is an example, Tom. That's a string literal. Notice the double quotes. A sequence of characters surrounded by double quotes is a string literal. Here, I have a string variable name of type string, and I assign it the value Tom. I'm going to gray out my string literal, and now my first statement that is going to execute is string name gets assigned Tom. Let's see how that looks in memory. On the stack, some memories are allocated for my variable name. It includes a reference because string is a reference type, and it refers to an instance, to an object, on the heap. Notice, here is an object on the heap, but we have not used the new operator. We have not called the string constructor. We used a string literal. So the constructor call happened for us behind the scenes. Let's see what happens if we declare a second variable. Let's see, name one. Once again, we are going to assign Tom. And on the stack, more memories are allocated, this time for name one. However, both of my variables have a reference to one and the same object. So the second time we assign Tom, no additional string instance was created. Now, why is this happening? Every time we use a string literal, class string checks whether it has already been created. So class string keeps track of the instances that have already been created. If it is already available on the heap, the same object, the same instance is reused, and both of the variables point to the same object. This is safe because strings are immutable. That means it is guaranteed that neither of the variables is going to modify this object. So both of them can point at the same immutable object safely. At this point, we created a new string based on a string literal, but it is also possible to call a string constructor explicitly. As a matter of fact, string has quite a few different constructors, overloaded constructors. I'm going to introduce one of them that is based on a character array. So here we could have a character array, I call it an array, like name array, and it includes the characters B, E, N. And then I declare a variable name 3, and I create a new string with the new operator and the constructor, and I pass my character array as an argument. So I want to create a string based on this character array. This is how it looks in memory. My an array is an array, so it points to an array on the heap. And now we create a variable named 3, and based on the element values, a new string object is created, in this case, Ben. Now let's look at some string methods. One frequently used string method is length. It returns the length of a string. Example, string name gets assigned Tom, integer length is name.length. Length is called on an instance because it doesn't mention static here, and it returns 3 because Tom consists of 3 characters, T-O-M. Another method is charAt. charAt requires an argument of type integer, that's the index. And then it returns as the character on that specific index. Let's have another example. String name gets assigned Tom. Name dot char at on position 0 gets assigned to my character C. So when I look at the character at the position 0, I need to know how the string characters are numerated. And I can see the first one is 0, second one is 1, third one is 2. So we start counting in 0, which happens a lot in Java. You saw this already with arrays and in other situations. And because we start counting at 0, the 0th character is T. And char at 0 is going to return T. Also notice that the last character has index 2. And the length of my name is 3. So the last character is name.length minus 1. Now it's your turn. Use methods from class string to complete the method printReverse below. So here is my method printReverse. It returns nothing, so here return type is void. And it has one parameter of type string. So we pass in the string and it just prints the string in reverse order. Give yourself a moment to write this method, pause the video, and when you're ready, press continue. Here is a possible solution. I'm using a for loop. I'm initializing my I with string length minus 1. This is my last character. I keep counting down until my I is 0, because I also want to print the 0th character, which is my first character. I decrement my I, and every time I execute the body of my for loop, I print the character at the given index. Let's have a look at yet another method, concat. Concat concatenates the specified string to the end of this string. Notice the return type is string. Strings are immutable. Even if a method appears to modify a string that is not happening, in reality, a new string gets created and returned. So here is an example. I could have two strings. Word 1 points to race, word 2 points to car. And now I declare a variable word 3 and I assign it word 1 concat word 2. So word 2 is appended at the end of word 1. Race and car together makes race car. A new string is created and word 3 points to this new string. The original strings, word 1 and word 2, remain unchanged. Alternatively, you can also use the plus operator. We don't have operator overloading in Java, but Java provides a plus operator for strings, and the plus operator does concatenation. So if I would say word 3 is word 1 plus word 2, once again we would create a race car string object, and word 3 would hold a reference to this newly created object. The plus operator is commonly used in print statements and also to break up long strings over multiple lines. If it is used in combination with objects that are not strings, then the toString method is called on these objects. Let's look at an example. Here I have a string word 1, which is race, and now word 4 is word 1 plus 3, and that would make race 3. So in this case, 3 is a primitive type int. That doesn't really work for a string concatenation. So my primitive type int is boxed to the wrapper class type integer. Now I have a string plus an uppercase integer object. At this point, the toString method is going to be called an uppercase integer. And the toString method for the uppercase integer 3 is the string 3. So raise plus 3 is raise 3.